Hi, I'm Mary Leisenring. Did you know that median household income for the nation decreased 2.9% from 2019 to 2020? Every year, the Census Bureau releases the Income and Poverty Report that provides statistics from the current population survey, annual, social, and economic supplement, or the CPS ASEC for short. In this data gem, I will teach you how to access the income data tables from the CPS ASEC for the nation. And we'll also discuss how and where you can find the data at the state level. Let me show you how to get there.
To locate income data tables, let's begin at census.gov. At the top, hover over Browse by Topic, click on Income and Poverty, and then select Income. On the left menu of the Income page, click on Data. The Income Data page has links to income data tables, data tools, and data sets. In this data gem, we're going to focus on income data tables that are available from the current population survey. Clicking on income data tables takes you to the tables available by year. There are three types of tables available that we will explore today: report tables, detailed tables, and historical tables. To give you a little background, the report tables include all income and poverty tables from the current income and poverty report, which include year-to-year and historical tables in Excel files. The detailed income tables show detailed income data by selected characteristics, such as age, race, educational attainment, and more. These tables are released each year, so keep in mind that previous year's data is not inflation-adjusted to the current year. The historical income tables show income data over time by selected characteristics, including current and inflation-adjusted income. Let's start with the report tables. The Income and Poverty in the United States 2020 link takes you to the tables used for this report. If you are interested in downloading the data as an Excel file, click on the table link. These tables are available at the national level geography. Here on the right, under Related Information, you can find the full Income and Poverty publication, including the report PDF, highlights, tables, and figures. Let's navigate back to the Income Data Tables page by clicking the back arrow. There are three current population survey table links that take you to detailed tables for family income, household income, and personal income. Family income includes income from all family members, two or more people related by birth, marriage, or adoption, living in a housing unit. Household income includes income from all people who occupy a housing unit, regardless of relationship. A household may consist of a person living alone or multiple unrelated individuals or families living together. Personal income is income received for an individual person. As an example, let's select current population survey tables for personal income. This table of contents page shows you the personal income tables, PINC01 through PINC11. The title for each table gives you the topic and the characteristics it's broken down by. Remember to also decide if you're looking for money income or earnings. Money income is defined as income received from a variety of sources on a regular basis before taxes. It includes earnings and unemployment, educational assistance, Social Security, etc. Earnings makes up about 76% of money income, and it's the sum of wage and salary income and self-employment income. Let's look at an example of total money income. PINC01 shows selected characteristics of people 15 years and over by total money income, work experience, race, Hispanic origin, and sex. Remember, these tables are published each year, so tables from previous years are not inflation adjusted to current dollars. Once you've selected the table, you can choose the income data year as well as choose from several iterations. For this table, iterations are first broken down by work experience. Clicking on Worked Full-Time Year-Round will take you down the page to that section. Then you have sex and race and Hispanic origin categories to choose from. Under both sexes, let's click on the table All Races to download and open the Excel file. This PINC01 table iteration shows selected characteristics of people 15 years old and over by total money income in 2020. For full-time, year-round workers, both sexes and all races, you can see the total number of people, income distribution, median income, and mean income, and Gini ratio by various characteristics, including residence, region, age, relationship, educational attainment, and tenure. Next, I will show you how to find tables that contain historical income data. There are four historical income table links: people, households, families, and income inequality. As an example, let's click on historical income tables, households. This page has all the household historical tables broken down by a variety of characteristics. For footnotes in the historical income tables, see the historical income tables footnotes link under the related information menu. These will help you understand changes made to the survey over time. For example, changes to race and Hispanic origin definitions, survey information, or processing changes. Once you find a table you're interested in, click on the link to download the table as an Excel file. If you're interested in income data by state, look for household income tables H8, H8A, and H8B. These are the only published income tables for the CPS ASEC that are at the state level. For more income data at the state level, you can download the microdata files and do your own data analysis. To find these files, you need to navigate away from income data tables and go to income data sets. The CPS ASEC public use microdata files contain data for households, families, and individuals. These files can also be used if our published income tables do not cover what you're interested in.
These are great resources for income data. I hope you find them useful. For more help with finding income data, send an email to the Income Statistics Branch at the Census Bureau at sehsd.isb.list@census.gov. To find more learning opportunities like this, go to census.gov/academy. While you're there, subscribe so you never miss an opportunity to learn with us.